With the perfect size. Wouldn't be a first. Now, as far as you want to leave now, we're not missing any of the folks that are coming in the immediate family.
Said, say a prayer for me. She threw her arms around him, whispered, God will keep us free. They could hear the riders coming. He said, this is my last fight. If they take me back to Texas, they won't take me back alive. There were seven Spanish angels at the altar of the sun. They were praying for the lovers in the valley of the gun. When the battle stopped and the smoke cleared, there was thunder from the throne. And seven Spanish angels took another angel home.
She reached down and picked the gun up that lay smoking in his hand. She said, Father, please forgive me. I can't make it without my man. And she knew the gun was empty, and she knew she couldn't win. But her final prayer was answered when the rifles fired again. seventh Spanish angel took another angel home.
There were seven Spanish angels at the altar of the sun. They were praying for the lover in the valley of the gun. When the bells stopped and the smoke cleared, there was thunder from the throne. Seven Spanish angels took another angel home. All right, y'all, help me now.
There were seven Spanish angels
at the altar,
at the altar of the sun.
Oh, I believe
they were praying for the lover
that it was
in the valley of the gun.
Well.
When the battle stopped and smoke cleared,
there was thunder
on the ground.
Oh, yeah.
And seven Spanish angels.
Grief never ends, but it changes. It's a passage, not a place to stay. Grief is not a sign of weakness, not a lack of faith. It is the price of love. Good afternoon. My name is Kathy, and I'm your celebrant today for the celebration of a life that was lived with love. The life of Shirley Miller. On behalf of myself, Shirley's family, and the staff of Stephen Baggs, I'd like to welcome you here today and to thank you for coming to remember and to celebrate Shirley's life. I know there are some that can't be here due to distance, and I'm sure they are sending their love. I would like to welcome Shirley's granddaughter Kylie and her family who are joining us from Canada. And I hear that she's sitting back having a glass of wine while she's joining us. And also Shirley's sister-in-law Rose, who is watching from England. Shirley was a much loved wife of Dennis, who was no doubt there to greet her on her next journey. She was a loving mother of Mandy, Kevin, Maxine, Karen, and Jonathan, who passed away not long after birth and will once again be in his mother's arms. She was my mother-in-law of Chris, Jenny and Shane, an adored nanny of Matthew, Sarah, Ashley, Adam, Kylie, Michelle, Angela, Skye, Nicole and Paige, and great nanny of 14. She was a sister of Denville, Zena, Suzanne. She was an auntie and a friend. Today is a day of sadness, but it's also a day that is filled with love and with memories. You'll hear a brief outline of Shirley's life through her eulogy and through memories that will be shared. And you'll also get to see a snapshot of her life through photos that have been chosen just for today. Following on from the chapel, Shirley will be privately cremated and her ashes will be reunited with her husband, Dennis. And they'll once again be together and will get to travel with Kevin to places that Shirley and Dennis didn't get to go. And just maybe Shirley is sitting down with the kettle on with Her Majesty the Queen Elizabeth and having a well-earned break with her. Following from the chapel, you're invited back to the Bairnsdale Bowls Club where you can continue to share your memories while you enjoy some refreshments. Shirley was born to proud parents Roland and Violet Newbury in England on the 22nd of September 1935. She was a second child of four. The family's life was hard as the Second World War was raging at the time, and there were many hours spent sheltering under the stairs in the family home in darkness. Shirley shared a memory with her family of how she was left-handed and will cop a few raps on the knuckle if she didn't write with her right hand. And I did notice there's a couple of lefties in here as well as I was signing in. When she left school, she worked as a housemaid before meeting Dennis and falling in love. They were married and started their life together at Wychampton in Dorset. Before they got married, Dennis was in the army and then he became a sheet metal worker. They started their family life with sadness when their first son Jonathan was born, but only survived for 3 days. However, they were blessed with the arrival of Mandy, then Kevin and Maxine, and later the youngest Karen was born. Karen suffered from disabilities, so Shirley's life was spent giving Karen the extra care that she needed. In 1963, the family all packed up and migrated on the ship called the Fair Skye to Australia as 10-pound Poms. Dennis and Shirley decided that life in Australia would be better for the family, and they embraced the country with all their hearts. They stayed briefly at Bayswater before moving into a shared dairy farm at Nyora. It was a wonderful 15 years spent there. They then bought a family home in Poowong when all the children except Karen had left. Dennis worked on a chicken farm, and Shirley stayed at home caring for Karen and loving it when her children and especially the grandchildren came to visit. Shirley and Dennis got to travel a few times, and Shirley especially enjoyed the holidays to Broken Hill, where her parents had settled after they too migrated to Australia. When Karen was put into respite, Dennis and Shirley had a wonderful trip to Tasmania, and Shirley even travelled back to England with Maxine. The hard decision was made, and Karen went to live in supported accommodation in Warrigal, where she would receive the care that she needed while living with others, which took a lot of the burden from Shirley. Not long after Dennis retired, he was given the heartbreaking diagnosis of Alzheimer's, so they made the decision to move to Bairnsdale, where they could be closer to Mandy. They bought a unit in Pearson Street and embraced the lifestyle here. When it became too hard for Shirley to look after Dennis, he was put into care at Sutherland Lodge, where Shirley stayed devoted to him and visited him every day. He passed away 6 years ago, which left a big hole in Shirley's life. It was then, when she was out walking her dog Tess the Pomeranian, that she got talking to a lady who was also walking her dog. And this lady was Margaret Carley, and a wonderful friendship developed. Shirley and Margaret would catch up daily for a coffee while walking their dogs, and Shirley's circle of friends grew. She was her happiest when the grandchildren were around, and she looked forward to drives to Lake Sentient for fish and chips or going on a picnic at Eagle Point. Earlier this year, Shirley was diagnosed with cancer, and after treatment was given the all clear before once again it returned. Last week, Shirley suffered a stroke, and even though she fought so hard, it was obvious that it was too much, and she passed away with family by her side on the 2nd of September at the Bairnsdale Hospital. The family would like to thank the nurses for the wonderful care they gave to their mum and to themselves during this sad time. Now, Shirley's grandchildren have got together and they've had a chat about their memories of their nanny, and Angela is going to come up and try to share some of those memories with us. Somebody else can come up and stand with the two if they want.
We were lucky enough to grow up. We were lucky enough to grow up with the best grandmother. Our school holidays were always spent at Nanny and Grandpa's house in Poowong, where our days were filled with adventures like going to the Werribee Mansion, the Melbourne Show, the heated pools, the movies, or the chocolate shop in Warrigal, where we would choose a bag of lollies each to go in the lolly tin. When we weren't out and about, we would rumble through Nanny's endless collection of movies. Not all age appropriate, mind you. Kylie recalls watching Rocky Horror Picture Show as a 9-year-old, and I wouldn't have been more than 5 when I saw Gremlins and It for the first time. We'd often spend our time making honey bears and lampshades, playing cards and putting on old records. Dolly Parton's Coat of Many Colours was a favourite. We had the endless support from both Nanny and Grampy, taking us to basketball tournaments, ballet concerts, netball games, horse shows, and if they weren't there to support us, they always called to see how we went. We thought the world of Nanny, and ask anyone, she thought the world of all her grandkids. I know we were spoiled by her and didn't think it possible for anyone to be more spoiled, but then enter the great-grandkids. She always had time to listen to their stories, and we could never leave without a little gift. Our fridge is proof of that, as it's covered in magnets from Lake's entrance. Nanny shared a special bond with each and every one of her grandkids and great-grandkids. When Nanny's dog Jess passed, to help with the loneliness, we offered for Nanny to come stay with us in Lancaster. Nanny's final 2 weeks were spent doing all the things she loved. She was able to catch up with her sister Sue for the day. They explored the coastal drive from Cape Patterson to Inverloch. Nanny was also able to spend the day with daughter Maxine and great-grandson John. They had a great time enjoying the local park. Nanny was absolutely smitten by John. She then paid a special visit to her great-granddaughter Amy, who was at work at Mitre 10. the highlight being feeding the magpie named Hamburger. Nanny was also thrilled to go and see her great-grandsons, Callum and Oliver, play basketball, and in true Nanny style, she thought they were by far the best on the court. When Nanny wasn't busy catching up with family, her days were spent out on the mail run with granddaughter Michelle and taking in all the beautiful scenery. It was noted that if they ever got bogged, Nanny would have to get out and push. To Nanny's amusement, this almost eventuated a couple of times. In the evenings, Nanny spent her time catching up on any animal show with great-granddaughter Jade and sampling things Jade had made. This was until they introduced Nanny to the documentary series Alone. Nanny managed to binge two whole seasons in 1 week. With the help of Facebook, Nanny was also able to view photos of all of her grandkids and their families, which she greatly enjoyed. Nanny thoroughly enjoyed her time in Langatha and was already planning her next visit. Sadly, the next time we see Nanny was 4 days later when we were saying goodbye. Although we are all sad that Nanny is now gone, I know her memory will live on with us. We will think of Nanny when we smell apple fabric softener. We will think of her when we taste cappuccino foam. When we are ironing, we will chuckle at the thought of her ironing our undies. When we hear the word splendour, we will think of Nanny and will always put aside a couple of sugar packets to add to her collection.
What's wrong with ironing undies? Is there anyone else that would like to come up and share a few memories as well? Okay, there's plenty of time back at the Bowls Club. I'm just going to read something, as I've mentioned earlier, that Margaret Carney is a very good friend, and Shirley's as well, and she's asked me to say the following on her behalf. I love my best friend dearly, and life won't be the same without her. We had many years of friendship and were always there for each other. I want to thank all of Shirley's family for allowing me to become a part of her life, and I will miss her dearly. I'd also like to thank Sue and Henry for the catch-ups that Shirley and I had in Warrigal, and I'd like to acknowledge Michelle, Amy and Jay for the wonderful times we all had together and the times that we had with Mandy, Chris, Sarah and Ashley, and Margaret's little friend, Ava and Lani, and a special mention to Kevin for the bottles of rum. When we look at photos, our memories go back in time to the time that they were taken if we were there, and we enjoy reflecting on these moments. Photos are also taken so that people that weren't there at the time will get to see the special moment and that memory can be shared. Shirley's family has chosen the following photos to share with you today to remember moments of her life. You may notice there are many photos of Shirley's grandchildren, and that's because they played such a special role in her life, and she would have wanted their photos to be a part of her life story.
Don't go looking through that old camphor box, woman. You know those old things only make you cry. When you dream upon that little bunny rug, makes you think that life has passed you by. There are days when you wish the world would stop, woman. But then you know some wounds would never heal. But when I browse the early pages of the children, then I know exactly how you feel. Hey, it's July and the winter sun is shining, and the Cootamundra wattle is my friend. For all at once my childhood never left me, 'cause wattle blossoms bring it back again. It's Sunday and you should stop the worry, woman. Come out here and sit down in the sun. Can't you hear the magpies in the distance? Don't you feel the new day has begun? Can't you hear the bees making honey, in the spotted gums where the bellbirds ring. You might grow old and bitter 'cause you missed it. You know some people never hear such things. Hey, it's July and the winter sun is shining, and the Cootamundra wattle is my friend. For all at once my childhood never left me, 'cause wattle blossoms bring it back again. Don't buy the daily papers anymore, woman. Read all about what's going on in hell. They don't care to tell the world of kindness. Good news never made a paper sell. There's all the colours of the rainbow in the garden, woman, and symphonies of music in the sky. Heaven's all around us if you're looking, but how can you see it if you cry? Hey, it's July and the winter sun is shining, and the Cootamundra wattle is my friend. For all at once my childhood never left me, 'cause wattle blossoms bring it back again.
Looking forward, looking back, I've come a long way down the track. Got a long way left to go, making songs from what I know, making sense of what I've seen. All the love we've had between you and I along the track. Looking forward, looking back, there are strange days full of change on the way, but we'll be fine. Unlike some, I'll be leaning forward to see what's coming. Looking forward, looking back, I've come a long way down the track. Got a long way left to go, making songs what I know. If I'm alone at night, I can see through all triviality of the day, and I'm okay. I just think of those who are dear to me. Looking forward, looking back, I've come a long way down the track. Got a long way left to go, making songs from what I know, making songs from looking forward, looking back.
Family photos are the most precious. And I'm sure she would have loved all those photos, especially with all the grandkids in them. All finished. Nearly. Would you please like to stand and join me in saying the Lord's Prayer? Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. We all know that you can never tell someone's life in a short period of time that we have at a funeral. So that is why you must continue to tell Shirley's life by sharing your memories with each other. In the days, weeks and years to come, there will be moments that will bring back a memory. Whether it's a song that you hear, maybe by Slim Dusty, John Williamson, or as you heard Dolly Parton, think of Shirley listening with you. Remember how you all enjoyed getting together for the Sunday family roast. And maybe you can have a Sunday roast every so often in Shirley's memory. Think of how Shirley and Dennis embraced the Australian way of life, even barrack for the Aussies when they played cricket against England. They always said that if you live in this country, you should barrack for it too. When the World Series cricket was on, there was always a crowd at Shirley and Dennis's to watch the game. Christmas was a joyful time, followed by the Boxing Day tests. Shirley loved to garden, and especially liked colourful flowers such as roses and lilies, and I'm sure she'd be thrilled with what we've got on her coffin today. Shirley would like to relax by reading love stories, in particular Mills and Boone's, which Kevin informed that she had so many of. She also enjoyed reading crime novels, which is a completely different story to the Mills and Boone's books. And as you heard, she liked to watch Alone. I don't know what you think about the new one that's just come out, Alone and Naked. Remember how Shirley would spend hours with the grandkids, making the little bears and the lampshades. And I'm sure they will be treasured for years to come. Think of the tin of lollies that Shirley always kept as a treat for the grandkids. That was referred to as well. She loved all animals, but in particular she loved dogs. As I mentioned earlier, she'd be seen walking Tess and enjoying the sunshine. And when there was a photo of Tess on the wall, I heard someone say, "There's Tess." However you remember Shirley, always remember her with love. And one piece of advice that she would give is to never put off doing something because you might not get the time. The poem on your booklet is how I'm sure Shirley would like you to think, but I'm going to close with a different poem. It has been written by a friend of mine called Pam Nelson. Some people light up rooms with their laughter. Others can brighten the world with a smile. Many will make you feel happy by sitting nearby for a while. Some folk can cheer up a cold day with just a few words or a glance. Others can make things seem better if you just give them half a chance. But there are those whose whole life is a blessing, not a smile, not just a smile, a moment or a word. They make all around them feel special, no person ignored or unheard. They give all they have and then give more while helping somebody get through. It's not about thanks or for mention, it's just something that's in them that they do. And when it's time they sadly must leave us, we grieve, but we also smile. We give thanks that our lives were connected and we were tucked in their hearts for a while. Thank you.
Bairnsdale, not the bowls club, so please go to the right place.